Now let's discuss the analysis procedure. In the analysis of combinational circuit, the input is a logic diagram. Some design is given to us and we are supposed to find what is the functionality of the design. So the output will be the set of Boolean functions that the circuit computes, or in otherwise we can represent the functionality of the circuit in terms of truth table. Or we can give the explanation of the operation of the circuit as well. The procedure is as follows. We have to label all the gate outputs using some temporary variable names, which are functions of the input variables. And we have to determine the Boolean function that the logic gate is computing from the input variables. Next, we have to repeat this procedure for other logic gates which take the input from either the input variables or the previous gates or both. And we have to find the Boolean function in terms of the temporary variables that we have used in step 1 and the input variables if necessary. We have to repeat this process till all the circuit output is computed. Then we have to back substitute for the temporary variables that we have used or the labels that we have given. And for each of the label, we have already determined the Boolean function. We have to substitute this Boolean function, and the final output of the circuit has to be computed in terms of the input variables. If we compute like this, we will be ending with the set of Boolean functions which the given logical diagram or the logic circuit computes. Let's consider an example. This is the circuit given to us. There are two functions, output functions, F1 and F2, which has to be found out, okay, what these functions are. So to start with, step number 1 will be we have to label the output of each of the gate which is accepting the inputs alone. Okay, so we'll be labeling this AND gate, OR gate and these AND gates. The order of the label doesn't matter. We have ordered this OR gate as T1, this AND gate as T2. Okay, it doesn't matter if we label this as T1 and this as T2, doesn't matter. And T3 we have spared for this one, this gate, and we have labeled this as T4, this gate as T5 and this as T6. We can now write what is T1. T1 is the OR of A, B and C. So T1 will be A or B or C. Similarly, T2 will be A, B, C, T4 will be A, B, T5, A, C and T6 will be B, C. The next step is to label the gates which are functions of either the input, the gates that accepts the input directly, or it is the input from the previous gates. Okay, so we will label this as, since this is going to be F2, the output of this OR gate is going to be F2. This will be F2 dash, and this is going to get the input from T1 and this F2 dash. So we will label this as T3. Now we have to find out what is the output of each of these gates. T3 is T1 and F2 dash. F1 will be T2 or T3. F2 is T4 or T5 or T6. Okay, so we get F2 equal to T4 plus T5 plus T6, where this plus stands for logical OR. Now let's back substitute for the temporary variables that we have used. So F2 we can write it as T4 is AB. So F2 is equal to AB plus AC plus BC, T6 which is BC, and A, B, C, all these are input variables, so we are able to write F2 which is one of the outputs of the circuit in terms of the input. Similarly, we have to find out what is F1. To compute F1, we need T2 which is ABC, which is directly in terms of the input variables, and T3 is T1 and F2 dash. So we'll find out what is T1. T1 is directly in terms of the input. F2 dash we need to compute. Okay, so F2 dash is AB or AC or BC, the whole complement. So we can use the De Morgan's law and write this as A complement or B complement and A complement or C complement. There are complements here which is not very clear, and B complement or C complement. Okay, and this we need to multiply with T1, or we need to make an AND with T1. We AND T1 and F2 dash. So we AND A or B or C with A bar or B bar, and we AND these two terms together. So when we make an AND, so A and A bar will get cancelled, A bar B will appear here, then A bar C will appear here, and B bar will appear, and then this term will get cancelled, B bar is 0, then B bar C will appear. Similarly, we AND these two terms and we get A bar B bar, then A B bar C bar, or A bar C bar, then C bar is C. And then we make AND these two terms and this get reduced to A bar B bar C, or A B bar C bar, or A bar B C bar. And F1 is T2 plus T3. And T2 is ABC. So we have ABC or these three terms. Now we have computed both F1 and F2 in terms of the input variables. So we now know the functionality of the F1 and F2 function, which are the outputs of the given logic circuit. The same thing we can compute using the truth table. ABC are the inputs, so they can take all the possible combinations from 000 to 111, and the directly computable variables are T4, T5, T6 and other temporary variables T1, T2. So we compute T4 which is AB, so we can just make AND of these two things and write. Similarly, T5 is AND of A and C, which we can compute. T6 is BC, so we can AND B column with C column and write the result. And F2 is now T4 or T5 or T6, so we can compute the output of F2 using these three columns, and F2 dash is the complement of this column, so we can directly compute this one. Now T1 is A or B or C, which we can compute from the input. T2 is ABC, this also can be computed from the input which is available. Now T3 is T1 F2 dash. We have computed both T1 and F2 dash. We can just make an AND of these two columns and get T3. And finally, we can compute F1, which is T2 or T3. So this will also give us the functionality in terms of the truth table. For what combination of input, we get a 1, and for what combination of input we get a Z. So this, if we wanted to, after getting the truth table, if we wanted to express these functions in terms of the input variables, we can use the Carnot map and find out what is F2 in terms of the input variables. We can get the simplified functions of both F1 and F2 using three variable Carnot map. This completes the discussion of analysis procedure of combinational circuit. We will move on to the design procedure.